I don't like to interrupt the interviews, so here's a quick message before we get started. Do you organize conferences or trade shows? What if you could create fully branded name badges with unique QR codes in only two clicks without a complex and expensive badge printing process that also includes on-site badging? What if your sponsors and exhibitors could download a smartphone app to scan badges and capture leads? No rented hardware or expensive on-site support, and real-time leads ready for import into their CRM systems. That's Curious. To learn more about the Curious smartphone-based lead retrieval, attendance tracking, and badging solutions, visit snapcapture.net. Welcome to the EventTech Podcast, live coverage of Planetech 2013. We're in downtown New York City at the Convene meeting space. Lovely meeting space, don't you think, guys? I'm John Federico, your host and executive producer, and joining me is Dino Dogan of Triber.
Hey, John.
How are you?
I'm great, dude. How you doing, buddy?
Good. Thanks for being so flexible. I appreciate just juggling the schedule.
Absolutely.
And I'm, of course, fascinated because now that I know what the title of your session is, I'm just totally intrigued. A Tribe Called Geek.
Yeah.
Well, so I'm half geek on my mother's side. That's what I tell people. And Clement's all geek. So I'm dying to know. So what is this? So what is A Tribe Called Geek?
So Liz and her team came up with the title. So I kind of had to backfit a presentation around the awesome title. I didn't know what it was about, but I knew I didn't want to change it because it sounds
awesome,
right?
Yeah.
So I started thinking about the words. One of them is geek. And to me, geek means knowledge seeker. And we're all seeking the knowledge to kind of hack this human operating system and build the tribe of people that will support us, whether it's an event or a brand or a company, whatever it is, right? It always takes a village. It always takes a tribe of people to do anything. So it's going to be all about that. How do we hack this human operating system? How do we learn about the human component of all this technology, right? Because technology is really secondary to human factors. So how do you get down to the human level and build tribes that will support whether it's your event or a company or a brand or anything like that?
Okay, interesting. Yeah. So the geek thing is, it's really about tribes, but this particular tribe happens to be one we all love.
Absolutely.
Okay, yeah. Got it. So interestingly enough, it's a tribe, and your company's called Triber.
Yeah.
So I guess this is a good place to start. So, What is it the Triber does? I know you have tribes of geeks, but you have tribes of many other tribes.
We have over 60,000 tribes.
Wow, I didn't know that. Okay. So what is Triber? It's for bloggers. I know that. And the rest I'll let you
get. Sure. Triber is really an ecosystem. We're trying to fix the blogosphere in a lot of different ways. And we're trying to ultimately complete the last mile for the creative class. Right. If you think about it, 20, 30 years ago, if you wanted to write a book or something like that, you had to go to a big publisher. Mm-hmm. Right. But now you can just publish a book on your own. Right. Right. 20 years ago, if you wanted to sell a book, someone had to run the credit card at Barnes & Noble. Right. Now you can embed a little PayPal code and process the whole transaction on your site. Right. But there's still the last mile. It's time for the creative class to start actually making a living through their creativity, which hasn't happened yet, right? You can't reliably make a living as a creative type, right? So that's the piece that we're trying to address. If you're a blogger, podcaster, YouTuber, whatever, right?
Sure.
You're the creative type, and you're competing for attention against a lot of big media properties, and they're soaking up all the attention, leaving very little for the rest of us. So Triber is an answer to that problem, right? Triber allows a bunch of little and medium-sized bloggers, podcasters, YouTubers, whatever, right, to sort of band together and tap into each other's audience, because you don't produce enough content to satisfy your audience's hunger, right?
Right.
Yeah, I mean, you'd have to publish 50 posts per day or something like that, and it's what Huffington Post does, right? You'd have to publish an insane amount of posts to actually, know, give them what they need, what they want. So instead of working so hard publishing crappy content like Huffington Post does, for example, or Mashable or BuzzFeed or whatever, right? It's just terrible content.
Yeah.
You tribe up with other people and you essentially you end up sharing an audience on whether it's Twitter, on Facebook, LinkedIn, even your blog. You can do a reblog. And essentially it's like retweeting the entire blog post along with the authorship and the comments. So the comments travel with the post as well. So we have some really cool technology.
Interesting. Okay, so the last part you just mentioned reminds me of, say, Tumblr.
But absolutely.
But what you're saying is Tribe allows this to happen on other platforms besides Tribe.
Self-hosted WordPress blogs.
Okay.
For now.
For now.
Which is what most meaningful content is written on. Sorry, Blogger.com people, right? most of the meaningful content is written in WordPress, self-hosted WordPress. Mm-hmm. Most serious bloggers who write, you know, who try to write quality content are on WordPress. And WordPress is open, so we kind of don't have a choice, right?
Sure.
So we're building that kind of ecosystem that exists on Tumblr, that exists on Twitter, that exists even on Facebook and whatnot. We're building it for self-hosted WordPress blogs.
So in this particular case, you talked about reblogging and, mm-hmm. and everything, including the comments. So it's not just link sharing, right? It's much more than that.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, it was never really about link sharing, right? You know, it's like I tweet your stuff or I post it on Facebook through Triber. Triber just makes all of that stuff easy. Geeks will appreciate this, right? At the heart of everything is a cost of transaction, right? So let's go back to like Gutenberg and printing press, 15th century, right? He lowered the cost of transaction of reproducing books, and the book industry exploded, right? Skype lowered the cost of transaction on long-distance phone calls, right?
Right.
All great platforms have that one thing in common, right? They all try to do that, lower the cost of transaction. So Triber tries to lower the cost of transaction for bloggers. And what do bloggers do? They write, they read, they comment, they share. So we make all of that stuff stupid easy. I mean, it's just so quick. You can do a lot more in a lot less time.
So stupid easy. How stupid easy? I would guess there's a WordPress plugin.
Yeah, there is a word. Now, you don't have to be on self-hosted WordPress to be on Triber.
Okay.
But it helps, right? So you can just plug in your feed or use a Triber plugin. Either is fine.
Okay.
But inside Triber automatically imports your new posts.
Okay.
So where like Twitter and Facebook and G+, they allow you to post to Facebook and Twitter and mm-hmm. G+,
right.
But that's not what they're built for.
Right.
You know, they're built for like one-on-one engagement or whatever, which never set really well with me because you end up building other people's empires with your bricks.
I agree.
You know?
I totally agree.
So Triber is set up from scratch to take your content, import it, and essentially it's a news feed. We just call it the tribal stream, mm-hmm. right? And it shows you posts from all of your tribe mates, and you don't even have to click. We're trying to save you from carpal tunnel down the road, right? You don't even have to click. You just hover over a little button, and whatever networks you connected, Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, whatever you connected, you hover over that button, it goes to approve, and it gets scheduled for later staggered delivery. So you can approve 10, 15 posts.
Okay. Yeah. Staggered delivery from another source to your source. Is that what you're saying?
Staggered delivery from Triber to your Twitter, to your Facebook.
To the sources that you specify.
Yeah.
Got it. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
And you can read inside Triber. And we really kind of, you know, bloggers are some of the most ferocious content consumers out there, right? So we created an environment where really kind of try to honor the reader, mm-hmm. right? So the font is nice and big. There's no intrusion from ads or anything like that. We even removed the links so you can open up the entire post and read the entire post right there. You can leave a comment. It appears on the blog. Hmm. So you never have to actually even leave the tribal stream to interact with the blog. We just pass it along.
Interesting. So it kind of reminds me of the Tumblr backend,
yeah.
right? In that regard, it's interesting though because Tumblr's not ad supported, right? And
it is actually.
Well, I'm sorry, it is. That's right, it is.
Yeah.
You can have sponsored posts and that sort of thing.
Yeah.
But in terms of display ads mm-hmm. or ad, you know, AdSense ads or that sort of thing.
Right.
that's not really, it's not really a concern. But by providing the reader, right, for in the tribal stream, mm-hmm. Do you get any pushback there? Do people say, well, I'm not getting the traffic, I'm not getting the clicks, I'm not getting, you know, my display ads shown? Any pushback there from the?
None whatsoever, and I'll tell you why.
Because they're happy with the distribution.
Yeah, right. Who do you want? Do you want just me, or do you want my 15,000 Twitter followers and 1,500 Facebook fans and 500 plus LinkedIn right. connections? Right. Which one do you want?
Right. Right. So it's easy for you to consume and say, yes, I'm going to repost
yes,
it, or yes,
exactly,
I'm going to share it.
Exactly.
Okay. Yeah. I figured as much, but I thought
yeah.
I'd ask.
Yeah. Great question.
So how long have you guys? 60,000 tribes. That's mm-hmm. a lot. So how many total media producers is that roughly?
I don't know. What's a media producer?
Well, you said
blogger,
it. Blogger, YouTuber.
Gotcha. So, first of all, we're keeping that number a secret until it's some ridiculously large number, so we can like go
that's
to
fair.
Press with it.
That's fair,
right? But I don't even know, to be honest with you, because even like 60,000 tribes, it's stat that I got from Dan Christo, my co-founder, mm-hmm. like 4 or 5 months ago. So I don't keep up.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, but it's a lot,
and it is.
And I would imagine the topics somewhat overlap, but what types of tribes are we looking at here? So we have geeks. We get the geeks out of the way. Yeah. So what else do we have? I mean,
So there's probably about 30 or so categories, and you certainly don't even have to start a tribe in that particular category. And even within a category, let's say marketing, you know, there's all sorts of different marketing, right? Mm-hmm. So categories is just one way to tribe up with people. One of my favorite ways is to connect with bloggers in real life on events like Planner Tech event, for example, right? And then bring them into tribe or bring them into my tribe and stay connected, mm-hmm. You know, as a tribe, right? So you can build event based tribe.
Right.
You can build a location space based tribe. When I lived in Tucson, Arizona, one of my favorite cities, I had a Tucson tribe. So it was across the board. One guy was talking about food reviews, another one was real estate agent, the third one was talking about like IT stuff, right? But they were all bloggers from Tucson. Right. They were all connected in some way, right? So there's all kinds of tribes.
Interesting.
Yeah.
So how long ago did you guys start? You mentioned Tucson, and obviously you were still there at the time. Now, I met Dan briefly at a it was the Hoboken Tech Meetup, and now it's the New Jersey Tech Meetup.
Yes, yes, yes.
I met him briefly there.
Right
and
on.
That's where I learned about Triber.
Yeah.
Actually, I think he presented.
He presented, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So how long have you guys been doing this, and when did you make your way out to New York City from Tucson?
So we've been doing it for 2.5 years. I've always been based on the East Coast.
Okay.
I just happened to have lived in Tucson for about a year because, you know, our business is online.
Right.
So as long as I have an internet connection, I'm fine. I can basically move anywhere.
Right.
So that's what that was.
Okay. Yeah. Gotcha. So about 2.5 years?
Yeah.
Okay. Interesting. So here, connecting at the, first of all, how did you get connected with Liz and this tribe?
She's a Triber user.
She is?
Yeah.
Oh.
She's on Triber. And also Deborah Parnell, I believe her last name is. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Deborah made the personal introduction because I've connected with Liz a bunch of times. We're in a couple of different tribes together. So I share her content. She shares my content. So we're in kind of a soft connection, you know, all the time.
Right.
And then Deborah got us on the phone, and we were actually kind of planning our own event that kind of fell through because we all got busy with our own thing. But yeah, I connected with Liz directly through Deborah, and here I am.
That's interesting. That seems like such a Liz thing to do.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely.
Because she's very plugged into this community in general, and she produces a boatload of content.
Yeah.
We don't produce enough. I shouldn't say that. That's why I produce this, right? Because
right.
I don't know. Writing isn't always.
Podcasting is great.
Work. Right, but this works for us because it's easy. It's easy to make things happen.
Do you embed your podcast on your blog?
Oh, sure.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There you go. Boom.
Yeah, it goes out in the feed, and we embed it in the blog, and the whole thing.
That's blogging.
Yeah, exactly. It's just,
you know, to me, content. You know, 48,000 years ago in El Castillo, Spain, they found the oldest imprint, hand imprint on the cave wall, right? Some caveman 48,000 years ago dried up some dust and blew it on a wall, right? To me, that's blogging, right? It's the same impulse to create something and leave an impression that existed in that caveman that exists in us today, right? Doesn't matter if it's text or podcasting or YouTube or whatever.
Well said. Yeah. Well said. I think we're going to leave it there.
Right on. Thank
you,
John.
That was great, you know. If people want to reach out, say thank you and connect, how can they do that?
Dino Dogan, at Dino Dogan. I'm on Twitter all day long. One of my secrets is that I actually started Triber so I can hang on Twitter and have like an excuse for doing it. Don't tell anyone.
Exactly. It's like, what do I do? I'm a social media expert now.
Yeah.
Now I can stay here. All right. That's great. At Dino Dogan. Dino, thank you very much. This is Dino Dogan from Triber. This has been the Event Tech Podcast, thank you. Coverage of the Planar Tech 2013 conference here in downtown New York. Thanks for joining us. Yeah.